Media recognition from Bloomberg, Reuters, recycling trade publications. Patented process for 100% recovery of critical metals, including cobalt, lithium, nickel, manganese, aluminum. American Manganese is focused on recycling lithium-ion batteries for electric vehicles. American Manganese trades on the TSX Venture, AMY, the U.S., AMYZF, and Frankfurt 2AM. For more information, visit AmericanManganeseInc.com or phone me, Larry Ray, at 778-574-4444.
Welcome to the Goddard Report. Comments made on the Goddard Report and TalkDigitalNetwork.com are an expression of opinion only. Here is Jim Goddard.
My guest is Sharon Noble, director of the BC Coalition to Stop Smart Meters. Welcome back to the show, Sharon.
Hi, Jim. Thank you.
Sharon, the U.S. has produced a report on fires caused by smart meters. Do you think that could get the attention of the BC government, which has ignored your extensive report on smart meter fires?
Well, you know, I think that there's a chance, and I'm hoping they will. This report was produced by someone who has spent the last 3 years going through the data in the U.S., and she has cataloged many fires, and she has spoken with electrical engineers, just as I did, and identified basically the same problems. And it's a repetition. But I think it's a good repetition. It's confirmation that what I found just by looking at the fires here in British Columbia can be duplicated and confirmed by experts and by records down in the U.S. And just as in British Columbia, the utilities down there are ignoring it. They're saying, nope, they're safe. And the insurance companies are still silent. I think that this is one of the crucial linchpins here, because the insurance companies know what's happening and they are silent. They are partnering with the smart meter program and the utilities in allowing our homes to be put at risk. I do hope that this report will be taken seriously. You know, sometimes hearing from another country, hearing from somebody who you don't know, makes a difference, and I sure hope it will.
So what did this U.S. report say?
It said that the meters are designed poorly. They're designed cheaply. They have many design features, such as no ability to ground when there's a surge, a power surge. There are aspects of it that spark, that cause hot sockets, that it's combustible. All of the things that I said in my report, and all of the meters, they didn't just look at Itron. They looked at many different types of meters. Landis-Gyr, Sensus, GE, Itron. They're all basically made the same. And this is what one engineer told me years ago when he took several smart meters apart and looked at them. He said the only difference is the faceplate. They're probably all made in the same factory in China. And they're brought here to the United States, and a faceplate is put on so that they could say that they were made in the U.S. They aren't made in the U.S., but that doesn't make any difference. The U.S. could make lousy, cheap stuff, too. The fact of the matter is, nobody has certified these to be safe. In the U.S., they tried, just as I tried here, and just as many people who were working with me tried, to get an independent certification from an independent electrical engineer working either for BCHydro or for Itron to certify that these meters are safe. And we couldn't get one. If an engineer did say such a thing, it's likely he could lose his license. So we were not able to get anything. When I asked BCHydro, Hydro referred me to Itron. When I asked for Itron, they referred me back to Hydro. We went back and forth several times. It was obvious that they either don't have it or they're not going to share it if they do have it. So that tells me if they had a certification, they would have shared it. And because they didn't share it, that means that no electrical engineer is going to say it's safe.
We'll have more with Sharon Noble right after this.
I'm Douglas Mason, CEO of Naturally Splendid, symbol NSP on the TSX Venture Exchange. Naturally Splendid is a biotechnology and consumer products company focused on the global cannabis and health markets. Naturally Splendid is expanding distribution in this rapidly growing market with products currently in Canada, the USA, South Korea, Germany, and Australia. To view our comprehensive company presentation and for more information, please visit our website at naturallysplendid.com.
Cypress Development Corp. is developing a world-class lithium resource in the heart of Clayton Valley, Nevada. The size of the resource makes the Clayton Valley project a premier asset with the potential to impact the future of lithium supply. Cypress Development Corp. trades on the TSX Venture Exchange, symbol CYP, the OTCQB, symbol CYDVF, and on Frankfurt, symbol C1Z1. For more information, please visit our website, cypressdevelopmentcorp.com.
Welcome back. We're speaking with Sharon Noble. Sharon, are any city councils in British Columbia concerned about the safety of smart meters or the health risks of 5G?
So far, Jim, it's been very quiet, but I must admit that we haven't, at this point, made serious presentations to a whole lot of councilors. And I'm hoping that that will change. One group in Pitt Meadows has been very active. And they have presented a lot of information to the mayor and council there. And this week, the council passed a resolution authorizing the mayor to write a letter expressing concerns about the safety of the levels of electromagnetic radiation that's in the air, about the siting of more cell towers in the community, which is being done now in support of 5G, and as well the fact that every utility pole, well, not every, I'm exaggerating, maybe every third or fourth utility pole is being made into a cell tower outside our home. And Mayor Dingwall in Pitt Meadows has written to the MP, Dan Rumi. He's written to Health Canada. He's written to various agencies expressing his concern and asking for a moratorium on the growth and the spread of this thing until people have a chance to find out if they're safe or not. He's asked for an investigation. Look at the science and tell us if it's safe. And he's expressed serious concerns about the fact that Health Canada is using safeguards, that's Safety Code 6, that was written many, many years ago based upon utility standards, based upon standards that the industry has put out there that are no longer adequate, if they ever were, and are a shame. They are one of the worst in the world, yet people like Hydro, people like TELUS, people like the various telecoms, even Health Canada, tell us that they are one of the best in the world. They just aren't. The Cancer Society says, so long as Safety Code 6 is followed, you've got nothing to worry about. We've got thousands and thousands of studies that say this just isn't true. And finally, we have a mayor and a council who has stepped forward and expressed concerns. And I'm so hoping that this will break the wall down and that more people will take this letter, take the evidence, and they can come on our website. I can put them in touch with people. We can give the evidence to take to their councils. And, Jim, this is very reminiscent of the smart meter issue. In 2011, I started off by doing a presentation before my council here in Colwood and asked them to present a moratorium on smart meters until they could prove they were safe. Councils, the local government, is given the responsibility under the Public Health Act to protect the citizens that are in their responsibility in their community, because they know, the counselors are the closest to the community, whether it's smoke in the air or dirty water or some other unsafe condition. It's their responsibility to raise it to the public or to the officials who are responsible ultimately. And in this case, it would be Health Canada. This council has done it. And with smart meters, we got 70. In the period between about February and August, we got 70 councils to ask for a moratorium that was ignored by Christy Clark. But the point is, the counselors knew it. They understood that smart meters were safe, and they came forward. And it's time they did it again. 5G is even more dangerous, and our environment is suffering big time. We can't take any more. And Health Canada is sitting on its hands doing nothing. It's time we stood up and said, look, we have a right to be able to live safely in our homes and in our communities. And we're not going to just sit here and let the federal government ignore it anymore. We've got to step forward. And I thank Mayor Dingwall and the Council of Pitt Meadows for stepping up and leading the way. It's wonderful. And we owe them a great deal of gratitude.
A lot of people may not be aware. Health Canada, you would think, being the boss of health across the country, would have a lot of labs to look after things and do their own independent testing. They don't even have a single lab. They depend on private industry to do their testing.
And they fall behind the World Health Organization. And it's kind of like a pyramid effect. The World Health Organization depends upon ICNIRP, which is an international group, but it's a for-profit group. It is, the people in ICNIRP are military people and industry people who have set the standards. The World Health Organization follows them, which is crazy. And then Health Canada and the other, like the FCC in the U.S., follow the World Health Organization. And then our provincial authorities, like it was Dr. Kendall before and now it's Dr. Bonnie Henry, the provincial health officers, follow Health Canada. We don't have any tests going on here either. But if you ask Dr. Bonnie Henry, she'll say she believes and follows Health Canada and the BC Centre for Disease Control. You check the BC Centre for Disease Control, they've got not one person there who has studied this or knows anything about it. They say that they follow the World Health Organization. So we are in a cycle here where no one is looking out for us on an independent basis. It's a free-for-all, and industry is the beneficiary of it. We've got to, again, this is the same thing. We've got to say no. We've got to say no to Bonnie Henry, and we've got to stop accepting the fact when she says that there's no evidence of harm. She's wrong, and she knows better. When the provincial health officer tells us this, and when the Cancer Society says this on their website, they're misleading us deliberately, and they need to be called on it. When Health Canada says it, when they put it up on their website, it kills me when parents care enough to write to Health Canada or to the Cancer Society asking about whether their children are safe in school with Wi-Fi or if their children should be using a cell phone, and they're told incorrect information that that agency knows is wrong. It is absolutely incorrigible. It's unacceptable. When parents are doing things, they're asking the right questions, but they're given the wrong information. And we've got to stop it. It's got to stop now with us. The public knows better now. We've got a groundswell. We've got so many people now who know that this stuff is dangerous. I get letters from people every day wondering why Health Canada is allowing this to happen. I don't have an answer except to say that there are people there who are in the pocket of industry. I know that people like James McNamee, who is the head researcher in the department responsible for Safety Code 6, he does his studies for Motorola. There is collusion there. There are conflicts of interest there that should not be allowed. And that our MPs are the people we should be going to and demanding that they stand up for us, just as the mayor of Pitt Meadow went to his MP. We should be doing it too, and we should be saying, if you want our vote, if you want our vote this coming election, then you've got to say, and you've got to show me right now, I'm not going to wait until you're elected. I want you to right now get out there and write to Health Canada and demand that they do their job. We're
going back to
lackadaisical here. You know, we accept politicians when they say, oh, if you elect me, I'm going to work for you. We've learned our lesson. This just doesn't work anymore. We say, if you're going to get my vote, you do it now, and I'll vote for you.
Sharon, going back to the U.S. Smart Meter Fire Report, how many fires did they have reported to them?
I'm sorry, Jim, I don't have the figures.
Dozens, hundreds, thousands?
She had a lot of fires. I didn't see her detailed numbers. I saw the summary. I saw the high-level summary. But when I spoke with her about it, she said many fires. There have been many fires. And one of the worst causes is power surge. And we've seen this over and over and over again. In my report, I outlined a few of them. Because, you know, there aren't that many that you can say is a real power surge. But when the utility company comes to your house and says, I'm going to change your meter. Now, whether it's changing it from an analog to a smart meter, or from an analog to an analog, or from a smart meter to a smart meter, that power should be turned off. When they do a live exchange, that is very, very dangerous. And I saw many fires. And if you go back through my report, you'll see lots of fires, lots of damages caused by just that little tiny power surge on a house, one single house. But there are major power surges, and these are the ones that she was documenting. The ones like happened at Summerland, that happened at Forest in Ontario, that happened in Sacramento and Stockton in California. When a car runs into a power pole, or there's a storm like there was up in Summerland, and the power went out. When the power comes back on, smart meters catch fire, smart meters explode off the house. Analogs don't do this. Only smart meters do. And this is happening. She documented quite a few of those incidents in the U.S. There was a major one in Florida that caused a horse ranch to catch fire, and many racehorses died.
We'll have more with Sharon Noble right after this.
Abin Resources Limited is a gold exploration company with significant projects in British Columbia and the Yukon. Trading on the TSX Venture Exchange, symbol ABN, and the OTCQB, symbol ABNAF. Surrounded by world-class gold deposits and mines, Abin's 23,000 hectares Forest Kerr Gold Project is located in the heart of the Golden Triangle in northwestern BC. For more information, visit us at abinresources.com.
Don't miss out. Stay informed. Receive the HowStreet.com weekly recap with thought-provoking podcasts, radio, and articles delivered to your inbox. Sign up for the HowStreet.com weekly recap on our homepage at HowStreet.com.
Welcome back. We're speaking with Sharon Noble. Sharon, are you relieved in any way that Public Safety Minister Ralph Goodale plans to hold a review of the 5G system and the risks, perhaps security risks, posed by Huawei?
Yes, if it occurs, if it's really an in-depth review. The announcement that Murray Rankin is going to head up a review committee looking at all aspects of security and cybersecurity is excellent news. And I've written to Mr. Rankin asking him if he's going to be including in that review Huawei and the fact that not just Huawei, but the entire 5G grid that's going to be set up is designed basically for the sole purpose of gathering our personal data, and that one of the key components of that grid are the smart meters that are on our homes already. I'm hoping that other people will write to him and encourage him about to look at this aspect and to express their concerns. Many people are concerned about the fact that their personal data will be gathered by the smart meter. From the time you get up, about everything you own, everything you do, your personal life in your home is going to be sent through the smart meter to the 5G collectors and out to the Internet of Things and onto the cloud. Everything you do in your car, ultimately everything is going to have a chip in it. And there was an interesting ad I saw that said, it showed somebody with a smartphone sitting in a car and saying, you will be able to look at your smartphone and see that your baby 5 miles away has a wet diaper on, because that baby's going to have a microchipped diaper. Really? Is this what we want? Our babies being exposed already, I mean, to so much EMR before they're born, even before they're conceived. The sperm is damaged, the eggs are being damaged, and now we're going to continue this with chip diapers? This is the thrust behind 5G, so that people can have more gadgets out there, doing more things, spreading more EMR, so that people have more data on us. So I think that we have to take some solace that maybe Mr. Rankin is going to be looking at this aspect, but he won't do it unless we tell him to. We have to tell him what our concerns are. But Mr. Goodale, I'm a little bit concerned. He did say in an interview that was transcribed in the Times columnist and other newspapers that there's a panel, and I don't know who's in this panel, I've asked, that is looking at every aspect of 5G. And he said every aspect of 5G technology, from cybersecurity, privacy, science. And then he said at the end of the interview something that concerned me, because I was thinking science, that means health. Maybe it doesn't, because he said this fabulous new technology, we have to make sure that our data is safe. I want to find out from Mr. Goodale who's on this panel and who is looking at the health side. We have to make sure that this is an opportunity for the public to get involved and, again, express our concerns. No one is out there looking at all of these things for us. We know that Health Canada is saying 5G is fine. We know that the World Health Organization is saying it's safe. It's not. We know that experts like Martin Paul, Henry Lai, Magda Havas, thousands of studies are saying this stuff is not safe, and not only are we going to be having more of it, it's going to be from transmitters, cell towers, right outside your home, mere feet from your bedroom window or the bedroom window where your child is sleeping. Furthermore, I think Mr. Goodale may not realize that Huawei is already here, is already in the grid. In part of his interview, he said that, and there was a separate article in the Times columnist saying that there was going to be a review, and the results probably wouldn't come out until after the election, about whether the government is going to approve Huawei's participation in 5G grid. They're here. They've made those transmitters that are in the microcells on poles outside our home. And there was an outline of the entire grid that was provided, a blueprint by Hydro and by TELUS, showing that Huawei's invested all the way along the line. They're involved in Site C. They are involved in the grid. All the infrastructure pieces along the way have components made by Huawei. And Huawei was a partner with TELUS in the pilot projects. And Huawei, as you said to me privately, Jim, is already operating in some of the rural communities up north. And I don't think Mr. Goodale knows this. I'm wondering if the federal government knows this. Who's approved it?
Well, they should know about it, because Prime Minister Trudeau announced and thanked them for setting up the 5G network in the north.
Well, read the article.
Yeah.
Because it says, you know, they don't know yet. They haven't given any approval. And they're waiting to see if approval is going to be given, but we have to wait until after the election. So, I mean, it's very confusing. If they haven't approved it, then why is it up there? And if Trudeau approved it, why doesn't anyone know about it?
Sharon, where can people go to get more information about these issues and topics?
They can go to our website, which is www.stopsmartmetersbc.com.
Sharon, thank you so much for being on the show.
It's always my pleasure, Jim. Thank you very much.
My guest has been Sharon Noble, director of the BC Coalition to Stop Smart Meters. You're listening to The Goddard Report on TalkDigitalNetwork.com. Find us on Twitter at TalkDigitalNet
our YouTube channel, Talk Digital Network. If you have any questions for our guests, you can send them to info@howstreet.com. I'm Jim Goddard. Thank you for listening.
Comments made on the Goddard Report and TalkDigitalNetwork.com are an expression of opinion only. The Goddard Report is available online and mobile at TalkDigitalNetwork.com. The Goddard Report is a production of How Street Media Incorporated.